So, what's up? Hey, y'all. I don't know if y'all ever tried these noodles. These are good noodles. They're only a buck. I think the little shrimp is in there. This is how it looks. You mix it. Y'all gonna miss the mixing because I just don't know how to do the thingy. But we're gonna mix it and we're gonna chit chat while I eat some noodles. I'm not afraid to eat noodles, okay? This life, you know what I'm saying? And it's a noodle kind of day. Like, I don't feel like really cooking. But I feel like talking to y'all. I hope you're having a good day on this Friday, okay? We already on November 2nd, okay? Let's talk. So this is it after I mixed it. How about there's no little noodles in there? No shrimp, rather. I don't know why. I just feel like y'all false advertise me, but it's good. It tastes good though. I did see one half of a rehydrated little shrimp, but that's all right. It's tasty. I'm gonna tell y'all, go try one. It's really delicious. Okay, let's get to the talking. Can I just tell y'all, it's been one of those days. You hear me? This day has not been a good day for me. It started yesterday, actually. No, you like, we can't see you, girl. I'm holding this camera. I got situated. My car. Oh Lord, my stylus. Where'd my stylus go? Come on. That's the one thing I can't keep up with. Did I put my stylus in my noodles? Almost. My car went out on me yesterday. That was cute. Alternator, what have you. Alternator, battery got changed. I was at the shop with my toddler from, not my toddler. She's eight. She my toddler. She gonna be my toddler. I got to the shop at 12. I left out that shop at 5 o'clock. So I'm like, okay, driving. Well, apparently I'm guessing the alternator isn't charging the battery properly. So I was running strictly off the battery, and when the battery died, the alternator needs to be fixed because the light still cut on my car, but it wouldn't get the battery going. So I gotta go later on, excuse me, today and take it back, which this is day two I've missed the work. When you're a single mom, missing work is just, it's a day ruiner. Is that a glare? I don't want to glare y'all to death. Oh, I did worse. I did that. Is that a little better? Did I break it? Ooh. What was I gonna say? Missing 2 days of work, it's rough. It's like I got vacation time. I got sick days or what have you, but it's the holidays coming up. Nobody's trying to spend their time up, you know, wasting it on trying to fix a dang on car. But it's looking like, because it's a, what do I have? A 2006 Dodge Caravan, I think. I love that car. It's no, it's paid for. Got a little rust on it, but it ain't hurt nobody. Okay, it drives just fine with the rust. Okay, the rust don't stop it. And it's like sometimes you get tired of the little, like it's not like it ain't the engine or nothing crazy like that, but it's still the point. I'm just, It's just the point that you miss where you had to cut into your time. So that's bothering me. Then my daughter has missed 2 days of school. It's like, really? That affects the attendance. So that was nerve-wracking. Trying to get a ride to go get your car to the shop. Everybody's at work. I'm nobody off. I don't have a bunch of unemployed friends. I mean, and my stay-at-home mom friends, they don't live near me. They live out of state. All my friends that I'm close to, they at work. So they can't even come take me to the shop until after 4, which means the shop will be closed, but the shop is open Saturday, so I can get it done Saturday. But today what I wanted to talk about was the word thirsty. why the hell is such an innocent word bad when you hear it? When it comes to showing that you're interested in someone. I'm 44. In all of my dating and relationship years, which has been probably 20, 25 years, I've been straightforward. I'm not a shy person. I've always felt comfortable if I met a guy and I found him attractive or he was just cool, I've never had a problem to anyone saying, hey, I think you're cool. You know, I'm Kiva. You know, what's up? How you doing? Just starting an actual conversation. And then if the conversation goes further, I see nothing wrong with reaching out to them to either keep the conversation going to see if they like you. But in turn, when we get a message, now we meet somebody and they reach out to you like, good morning, the next day, or maybe even every morning they just text you, good morning, how's your day going? You know, or they try to reach out to you and they call you. Because I one other thing, this is off topic, don't text me to death. Don't WYD me to death. You know what I'm saying? Pick up the phone and talk. I'm not a textual relationship type of person. You're going to let me hear some voice. Excuse me. You're not going to make me out to be as I'm chasing you. But there should be, when you're trying to get to know someone, there should be a mutual chase, shouldn't there? And it's not a chase, but people have defined thirsty. Oh, you all on my D. Y'all all on me, calling me. But a casual call here and there, that's what you should do, right? This generation is just backwards. There's a difference between being a nuisance, a bugaboo, and genuine interest. People are mistaking and confusing general interest in a person with what they're defining as thirsty. I'm thirsty now. And because I'm thirsty, guess what? I got my water. Like, that's thirst. This is a big boy too from the Dollar Tree. Oh, fuck, sweetie, Jesus, Lord, I love it. I love it. Ooh, I love water. I love wine. That's a different story. But we got to stop as adults, even as young teens of dating age. I want to say 17, you know. And yeah, they focus should be on the books, but let's be honest. Dating starts around there. I know a lot of people that's married their high school sweetheart. They were 16 when they met and 17 and they're married. So they had to show some interest. They had to know how to talk to a person, how to date. And I think that's where we're losing touch with general dating, even on dating apps. And I've met some really nice guys off of dating apps that a relationship didn't develop. But we're friends. You know why we're friends? Because we showed interest. We weren't thirsty. Thirsty, when we got thirsty, we got something to drink. But we reached out. We chatted. We talked. I'm just annoyed. I had a guy actually say to me, you know, I be wanting to speak to you, but I don't want to come off as thirsty. Wow. That's where society has people, the thirst. I'm in my pajamas, too. It says, I love to sleep because I do. I do. I love it. It loves me. It loves me right back. It feels so good. Yes. Loving some sleep. When sleep loves you back. Teddy Pendergrass would not approve of that karaoke moment. But that's real deal Holyfield. Love my sleep. But yeah, I just was like, what's y'all thoughts on being thirsty? And I understand you do get the bugaboos. You can get a woman or a man. This isn't a shade to any gender. Anyone can be a bugaboo. Anyone can overdo it. That's still not being thirsty. That's just you a nuisance. And it's nothing wrong with saying, hey, you know, you bugging me. Why can't we just be honest and say what the person is doing? Like, I don't respond to a text at 6 a.m. I don't care if you know I'm up every morning at 5:45 because your common sense, and maybe I've told you, I have school-age children. They have to be to school, and I have to be to work. So more than likely, I'm up at 5:30, 6 o'clock, getting my kids ready for school and off. Why would I want to have a full-blown conversation? I don't care about, I just want to text you good morning, because when you respond, at odd hours. Oh, hey, good morning. Here come a whole conversation. I don't be feeling like talking, so half the time I don't even respond to a conversation that hits me up. Somebody that speaks to me at 6 a.m. I catch them like around now, like, hey, I saw your text. I'll acknowledge it. I saw your text, but I was getting ready. You know, good morning. How's your day? Now we can go from there. But bugaboos can just, like, I never understood, like, Facebook Messenger allows you to call people. I think Snapchat, Instagram, many apps would just let you call a person without having their actual number. I've never found that to be cool because I'm like, if I don't give you my actual number to reach out to me, don't just call me on your phone. Like, hello, you know, just text me. I'm making a video. What's wrong?
I get candy.
You had some candy already. I'm gonna give you a little Halloween candy in a few, okay? I'll bring the bag down and let you pick
it. I can't
get
it.
Kiana.
I just can't get it.
Since you're still talking over me, go have a seat and you're not getting candy right now. All you had to do was just wait a moment. Yeah, mommy mode. But that, you know, if a person is bugging you, say they're bugging you. But I don't ever define anyone as thirsty. You know, when you're a genuinely interested person, you are supposed to communicate every day. And if not, I don't mean every day. Even if it's once a day, but it's just just checking on you, touching bases. Why is that thirst? Who stopped with the thirst? We're adults. That's a pet peeve of mine. When people call you thirsty, because I'm just going to say you bugging me or tell me I'm bugging you, you know. And if you a little overzealous, you know, because maybe you like the guy, you know, and you like, oh, I didn't hear from them today. I wonder how they doing. Do you know sometimes this, let me say this. When you just meet a person, do you know you kind of got to go on a roster? And I don't mean a roster of different people. They just met you. They've not been talking to you at all. So that means they have to kind of remember, oh yeah, I just met such and such. Let me put them in my my memory bank to speak to them because I just met them. I don't even know nothing about them. I'm not used to communicating with them. So you might get a day where they don't speak to you or you don't speak to them. That's okay. That's okay. And if I met someone and never heard from them again after 48 hours or a week, I'm not going to be like, I'm going to just move it along. Also, let me say this. If I should see a person message me or reach out to me and we have zero interest, like I don't like they look, because looks count. If you're just not cute to me or I'm not cute to you, that is what it is. I don't take offense. I'm not cute to everybody. Oh, okay. If you're not aesthetically pleasing to me, I don't care for your dress. I don't care for your pics. I don't like your posts. If it's just, we don't really got nothing in common. I'll probably say, hey, how you doing? Let me just be upfront. I'm not looking to currently date right now. You want to casually chit-chat? We can do that, but I'm not up for dating. Now, I've let the person know. Your conversation need to take a little turn from wherever you thought it was going to go. And if you cool with just reaching out to me and we chit-chatting from time to time, well, cool. If not, don't ever message me again, and it's no love lost. Why do you get some people that take that and go with, you know what, F you B, you fat B, because you always going to be fat if you a plus size chick. You always going to be fat when you get rejected. You know, you think somebody pressed to talk to you. I didn't say you was pressed. I just let you know up front, I'm just not interested if you were having that train of thought. I'm just big on not wasting anyone's time. I just feel like time is so precious. People have stuff to do, and what they can be doing is not having their conversation wasted on someone that they kind of feel like they want to talk to a little deeper than just hello and hi. That's just me, so I just knock it out in the first sentence, you know. And if I think I would like to talk to you, then we'll get past just the hello. Nothing like a piece of your weed going in your mouth while you're chewing. Mm-mm. That one for me. I want about that life. So, what's y'all take on thirst? Like, what is thirsty to y'all? Do y'all think thirsty is real? Like, I just hate to hear it. It's like, it's not. Ooh, my lid ain't on good. Yes, I drink like that for real. If y'all watched my previous video, that's how I drink. I am sorry. But let me know, what's your thoughts on this so-called thirst? I don't think it's real. I'm trying not to give y'all this glare, but I just wanted to sit and chat. I didn't really take the time to, you know, set my phone up or anything. It's just in my hand and I'm talking. Yeah, the thirst. I think if you're interested in a person, show them interest. If you're not, tell them. And being interested in a person and pursuing them in a timely fashion is, that's not thirst. That's interest. That's trying to see what will develop. And not everything, not everybody you meet, guess what? How about this? Not everybody we meet is supposed to be a relationship of dating. Do you know you can meet people and they're supposed to just be a friend? Why? That's not a bad thing to just meet someone and they your friend. People of the opposite sex. Why is my tongue tied? People of the opposite sex are capable as adults to just be genuine friends. As the friendship grows, you don't, have to date everybody that you meet. It can just be, that's my boy. He cool peeps. That's my girl. She cool peeps. And you still can meet another person and date them and they can still stay your friend. But some people don't have that adult concept. It's like, if I meet a man, he's got to be my man. Period. Or that's what it's automatically going to lead to. Because if, and I get it, the concept is, you know, I'm out here dating, I'm on a dating app, or I'm going out to meet people, because you may go to the club, you may be walking in the supermarket. Oh, he's cute. Oh, she cute. Okay, she looked at me. All right, now. I see you. You know, and then y'all connect. And then after it's all said and done, they just cool people. It's not for us today, but they cool. Personality on bond, but just not of the dating aspect. I don't see anything wrong with that. We're adults. We're supposed to interact and meet new people. And not all the time, just it happens. So give me y'all thoughts on the thirst. Like, do you think thirst is real? The concept of the word, do you think there is a thirst? Or has society really just jacked us up using that term? Because I don't like it myself. I am not a fan of the thirst. No, it's the interest. It's the, I found your conversation cool and I want to continue it, and reach out to me. Let's talk. You know, I don't see anything wrong with that. So I'm going to go back and my dang on car. Why does it seem like the universe is forcing me to get in the car? No, I'm just like, are you kidding me, universe? I don't want a car note. I don't desire it. And are you like, you just talked about that. Because it's bothering me. Shoot. But I'm here. I'm trying to be productive. You know, like, it's like, since I didn't go to work, I want to make this day of something. So I got laundry, a pile of it. It's a pile. You hear me? It's a pile. It's like, hello, girl. I'm going to finish my noodles. My scrimp noodles. Finish my noodles. Knock this pile out. Starts my laundry. Wait till I can get my car where it needs to be. And, you know, I'm gonna let fate do what it do. If I have to get a car note, then so be it. And I actually got my eye on a Kia. Let me tell you why I like Kias. Kia, and you probably familiar with Kia. They have their 500,000. Did I say, is it 500,000 or 100,000? Probably 100,000 mile warranty, or 5 years, whichever one comes sooner. They give you the free oil changes. I think they have one of the most outstanding car warranties. They have some cute cars and some ugly cars too. I like the Kia. Is it the Forte? F-O-R-T-E? Forte or Forte? Either or. I like that car. All right. Phone ringing. Y'all have a good one.